bad prognosis. A Bose tumor, so keywords, is a very, very big bones, and we make biopsy for genomic and future chemotherapy. For the medullary tumors, it is more better, more benign. Pilocytic astrocytoma, the WHO is grade 1, and you can make here a surgical resection, so the prognosis is very good. So the key word is hypodensity because low cellularity, exactly as pilocytic astrocytoma. So localization is always the medulla, not the bones. You have an exophytic tumor and you could perform surgery. So it is a good prognosis. So you know all you have to know in the posterior fossa tumors in children. So what do you perform for the sequences? So in practical, you have to perform a sagittal T2 or a cube T2. If you have the cube T2, it's better. For the ventriculocisternostomy, I show you here. Once again, the third floor, it is very, very important to give to the neurosurgeon. You have to perform a 3D T1, a coronal fluid diffusion, and a contrast annihilation. And you can't forget that the spinal MRI with gadolinium in sagittal T1 in case of medulloblastoma, in case if it is hyperdense on the CT scan without injection. So, the posterior fossa surgery and intellectual outcome. After treatment, we have seen that there are neuropsychological profile with learning disabilities and impaired visual spatial skill and attention deficit. And the risk factor identified were the young age, the use of radiotherapy, and the surgical complication. And for the complication, we see after review all the MRI for the outcome that the surgeon has to protect the cerebellum and to avoid the vermian section and have to preserve the dentate nucleus. It is very, very important for the outcome. If you have one dentate nucleus, you have 80 IQ, but if you don't have a dentate nucleus, it is very, very poor. So, the part two, suprasellar median tumors. So, you have to perform CT scan and MRI, and for the MRI, the spontaneous T1 is very, very important. So, we are going to see the optic pathway. A third of patients with optic pathway glioma have an association with neurofibromatosis type 1. And it's a group who grade 1, it is an astrocytoma. And I go quickly, it is a well circumscribed soft gray mass. Here you see the optic tract extension. And when you have an optic pathway glioma, you should see always the optic nerve. Here you have an enhancement, but it is not mandatory. You have to see the chiasma, the optic tract, and also the radiation, and here we have an important enhancement. So, the NF1, when you have a glioma at the chiasma, you have to search for the FASI, the focal area of signal intensity, and you have hyperintensity in the pallidum sometimes, in here, in the cerebellum, in the pons, sometimes in the brainstem, and in the pons also. But you don't have a FASI with enhancement. It is very important. It is a differential diagnosis with an astrocytoma. The FASI don't have enhancement. So for the treatment, quickly, we have chemotherapy, but we have also surgery. So we have a binocular approach for the treatment. Sometimes we begin with the chemo and after the surgery, and sometimes it is the opposite. So, optic pathway, you have an homogeneous mass, the localization is a chiasma, you have a variable enhancement, and you have to search for a neurofibromatosis type 1. For the craniopharyngioma, 10% of all pediatric intracranial tumors, it is benign, and you have always, always the same sign. You have the associations with a cystic supracellar and supracellar mass with calcification and solid components. Here you see the calcification, here you see the enhancement, and here you see the cyst. And you have the association of these signs, always. On the T1, you have a hyper intensity that reflects protein, cholesterol, and blood product in free. Here you have the announcement, and sometimes the announcement is here, it is a cystic announcement. I show you a lot of craniopharyngioma, it is always all heterogeneous. So, before 2005, the neurosurgeon relapsed all the third floor, and after 2001, they limit the sequelae, and you see here the BMI and the quality of life and the neuropsychological dysfunction were significantly correlated with the hypothalamic damage. So the goal for the neurosurgeon is not the vision, not the control of the tumor, and not the endocrine function, but the neurosurgeon have to prevent the hypothalamic disturbance and restoration of an acceptable quality of life, and they have to avoid hypothalamic damage. It is very, very important in a craniopharyngioma to know that. So the key word, you could have hormone deficiency and visual disturbance, heterogeneous mass, it is cellular and or supracellular, bright, spontaneous, on T1, very important, heterogeneous, and the key point, you have calcifications, cysts, and the solid component. For the germinoma, you have the peak age is 10 to 12 years old, and you have, it's very, very, very important, the diabetes insipidus prior to MRI anomalies. You could have a precocious puberty and headache, a visual loss, and a hypothalamic pituitary dysfunction. In germinoma, it is malignant and metastases are frequent. So you have to perform a spinal MRI for the metastasis, and the treatment is chemo and radiotherapy. So you see here, early, a germinoma, posterior pituitary bright spot may be absent, is absent, and after the injection, you could have an increase of pituitary stalk studies. Here on the CT scan, you have a hyper density to gray matter. It is homogeneous without cyst, and you could have punctate calcification. It is on MRI, on TY with injection, a mild homogeneous, diffuse, and strong uniform enhancement. Necrosis or hemorrhage are uncommon. Yes, on T2, you have a non-homogeneous mass here on cellular and here on the pineal region, and it is a bifocal germinoma, and here you see the enhancement, and you see the tumor is very homogeneous. So young patients with diabetes insipidus, please, please see to the germinoma and perform a T1 without injection and see the posterior post-hypophysis. So, for the clinical main features, we have a diabetes insipidus for the germinoma. The mass is homogeneous, very, very important, very different from craniopharyngioma. The pituitary stalk is important to see, and also the pineal gland for the bifocal localization, very important here. On the MRI, you have no posterior pituitary bright spot, and it is homogeneous, strong uniform enhancement, and don't forget that germinoma is hyperdense and could metastasis, and you have to perform here the spinal MRI. It is the only case you have to perform in supracellular mass the MRI. So, very quickly, because we have seen yesterday the epileptic tumor, so the DMT, we have a hypointensity, cortical hypointensity without edema, without mass effect, hyperintensity in T2 and flare here. So the keyword was cortical, and classical no enhancement in children. It is not the same thing in adults. For the ganglioglioma, the low grade and the grade 1, sometimes 2, we have exactly the same thing with a nodular enhancement, and the treatment is a surgery. Only, we have seen yesterday, hypo-intensity anti-1, hyper-intensity on flare anti-2, and a nodular enhancement. For the oligodendrogliomas, we have seen the low grade, and when you have a low grade, you have a whole grade 2 or 3, and in a high-grade oligodendroglioma, you have a progressive microangiogenesis with microvascular proliferation and necrosis. So in low-grade oligodendroglioma, you have an indistinct border, and hyper-intensity mass effect, but no contrast enhancement. And in high-grade oligodendroglioma, it's exactly the same thing with a contrast enhancement, as you see here. And you have here the tumoral infiltration in hyper-intensity on T2 and flare and hypo-intensity on T1. And it is an infiltrative tumor. It is the key word. Here, you have an indistinct border. It is very, very, very different from glioglioma with the enhancement and the oligodendroglioma with or without enhancement, but indistinct border. Very, very important that, to see that it is cortical, subcortical, and not cortical. So to finish the the malignant tumor, you have to see the localization, the cyst, and the sharp versus indistinct border, the contrast enhancement, and a very important side is the